Back when the Source engine first debuted over 25 years ago, its lighting engine was considered cutting edge for the time. However, as technology has advanced over the past two decades, its early 2000s limitations and Quake origins are becoming increasingly apparent, especially its heavy reliance on static pre-baked lighting. This is why we've been hard at work on a new renderer, leveraging a technique called clustered shading. Simply put, the clustered renderer is a complete overhaul to Source's original direct lighting system, shifting most of the processing onto the GPU, eliminating the need for it to be compiled into a map. This results in far more dynamic and immersive environments than was ever previously possible in the Source engine, all while remaining fully compatible with old maps. In Source's original renderer, expensive lighting calculations had to be performed once per pixel per every light in the scene. This is a very time-consuming process, especially when there are multiple lights present. With the clustered renderer, we've lowered the number of light calculations required to render a frame with dynamic lights by several orders of magnitude, allowing many more lights to be rendered much more efficiently. While we won't be diving too deep into the technical details today, we will be releasing a separate video going in depth into how the clustered renderer works later down the road, so stay tuned for that. For now, let's focus on how these improvements impact the visuals of Portal 2. The renderer now supports far more real-time shadowed lights. In vanilla Portal 2, if mappers wanted to create dynamic lights with real-time shadows, they were limited to an entity called a projected texture, of which only a single instance could be active at any time. This form of light was used extensively throughout Portal 2's campaign, and while for Strata we had already increased the limit of these entities to 8 per map, our new clustered renderer allows us to do far better. In the new renderer, all light entities in the engine can be rendered dynamically and cast real-time shadows, all while retaining the pre-compiled bounce lighting from the original renderer. Additionally, specular effects from all dynamic light sources are now applied to all surfaces of the world, rather than only on props with only some lights. This allows the properties of different materials to really shine, with different surface types reacting to light in a more realistic way. When combined with our new PBR shader, maps look much more lifelike and immersive. Alongside this, we've also given mappers much more control over the lights themselves. Mappers can now define how dynamic they want each light to be, ranging from fully pre-compiled to fully dynamic, and gain much more flexibility in defining the quality of shadows, including the ability to change their resolution at runtime. As a result of these changes, mappers now have the ability to make their levels feel vastly more dynamic than ever before. We're only beginning to explore the possibilities that the new renderer unlocks for both us and mappers, and we're eager to discover new ways to enhance the gameplay of Portal 2. We've already taken the opportunity to add some exciting enhancements to other core aspects of Portal 2. For example, portals now have the ability to generate high-quality dynamic lighting of their own. Dynamic portal lighting properly interacts with the surrounding world, helping to ground portals in the environment in a much more visually pleasing way than was previously possible. Further, we've added configurable dynamic lighting to a number of Portal 2's other entities. All of these extra additions are fully toggleable in the game settings, so if you aren't a fan, then you can configure them to your liking. That's about it for today. The new clustered renderer is available now for all beta testers of Portal 2 Community Edition to use, and we hope you enjoy playing or creating maps with these expanded capabilities. We're really excited to see what you create. To learn more about Portal 2 Community Edition, please visit our website and join our Discord server. Links to both are down below. Also, if you have experience with the Source engine and want to try out the game for yourself, apply for our closed beta. We always appreciate the help with finding bugs and suggesting features. Links for that are also in the description.